Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the exam analysis and paper analysis of SSC CHSL Tier 1 exam, which was conducted today, that is on 8th July 2019. So now let's see the details into the exam. So most of the students, 90% of the students who gave SSC CHSL Tier 1 exam on 8th July 2019 told that the paper was very easy. Few students told that the paper was moderate. So if you are a frequent preparer, or like if you are frequently prepared for SSC CHSL, you are going to rock this exam, because this year's paper, especially today's paper, was very very easy compared to previous years. So the overall paper of SSC CHSL 2019 Tier 1 exam was estimated to be easy, as so it was easy. So now let's see a few more details about today's exam. So coming to the general intelligence and reasoning, out of 25 questions, if you have attempted 18 to 20 questions, it means you have given a good attempt. Coming to the general awareness, out of 25, if you have at least attempted 16 to 18 questions, it means that you have done very well with your general awareness as well. So coming to the English comprehension, out of 25, if you have at least attempted 20 questions confidently and correctly, it means that you have given good attempt for English comprehension as well. And coming to the quantitative aptitude, out of 25 questions, if you have attempted at least 16 questions correctly, it means that you have given a good attempt for quantitative aptitude as well. So out of the complete paper, English was very easy. After English, general intelligence and reasoning was very easy. After that, quantitative aptitude was very easy. And after quantitative aptitude, general awareness questions was estimated to be moderate, because compared to the previous years, this year's paper was moderate, and compared to the previous year's papers, general awareness was very easy. So the students who are going to give the future attempts of SSC CHSL, please concentrate mostly on the general awareness, because the questions from general awareness was unexpected. Like few questions were from history, current affairs, which was a bit tough compared to the other sections. So please concentrate mostly on the general awareness. After that, concentrate on the English as well as general intelligence equally. So now let's see what are the few more details. So there is negative marking. So please don't take the risk of guessing the answers. Please don't take the risk of just guess marking the answers, because there is a risk of losing your marks unnecessarily. If you are really confident, then only just go for the answer, go for attempting the answer. If you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff, then it's your personal choice of you may take the risk of guessing the answers then. Only if you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff, else please don't take the risk of guessing, okay? So coming to the English, the paper was very easy compared to the other sections. So just concentrate on the previous year's questions, because most of the similar pattern questions were being asked even in today's exam of SSC CHSL. So concentrate mostly on the previous year's question papers and previous year's patterns, which were mostly repeating every single year. So now let's see English level topics. So out of the complete topics, closed test passage, 5 questions have been asked from closed test passage. If you concentrate on closed test passage, you can happily attempt 5 questions easily. So the closed test passage was very easy compared to the other questions. And after that, spell corrections, that is spotting the errors, the questions, 2 questions were asked from spotting the errors, and one word substitution, 2 questions were asked. So it was very easy as well. And coming to the synonyms and antonyms, as usual, four questions from each, from together, that is two questions from antonyms and two questions from synonyms. Concentrate more on antonyms and synonyms as well, because the questions will be little logical. So, and then concentrate on fill in the blanks. Two questions were asked from fill in the blanks, which were very easy. And coming to the sentence improvement, the questions which were asked from the sentence improvement was moderate. Two questions were asked from the sentence improvement as well. And coming to the direct and indirect questions, one question were asked, but it was very easy. So please concentrate mostly on the closed test, because it has five questions, like the direct five questions from the closed test. So coming to the quantitative aptitude, now let's see what are the questions asked from which kind of chapters. Okay, so coming to the as usual data interpretation, from data interpretation bar graph were asked. And coming to the bar graph, four questions were asked from data interpretation. So please concentrate mostly on the data interpretation, because if you are perfect with the data interpretation, you can happily answer four questions very easily. And next, the questions were asked, like two questions were asked from trigonometry, and coming to the geometry, three questions were asked. And after that, coming to the percentage, one question was asked. And coming to the number system, one question was asked. And coming to the time and work, one question was asked. Compare it to any other, concentrate more on the average problem questions, geometry, mensuration, trigonometry, and data interpretation. It was very easy and important. Concentrate on the sections which I told you. So coming to the general intelligence and reasoning, three questions were asked from series, always as important. Series was always been the important part coming to the reasoning. So please concentrate on series, and also concentrate on the analogy. The questions, three questions were asked from analogy, which was very easy. Coming to the odd one out, it was very easy. Three questions were asked from odd one out. And coding, decoding, concentrate on the coding, decoding as well. And coming to the paper folding questions, two questions were asked from paper folding questions. Out of the complete overall general intelligence and reasoning, the paper was moderate. And also concentrate on the blood relation and mirror image problems, because coming to the blood relation, one question was asked, which was like direct question, very easy. But compare it to the previous years, the paper folding question was a little logical. So please concentrate on that particularly. So coming to the general awareness, the questions were asked, which were like, so now let's see what are the questions which are asked in today's exam. One of the question was, they asked about who is the founder of Vikramshila University, one of the important questions. So the students who are going to attempt this exam in the coming up shifts or coming up days, please concentrate on this question. And one question is asked related to the hypertext markup language. Please concentrate on that as well. And the questions were mostly asked about the politics and general intelligence, and also current affairs. So concentrate more on these particular questions. And also the question were asked from so the question has been also asked from the politics, Olympics, and the history, name of the name of the ruler of the particular place. So such kind of history and politics related questions have also been asked. So please concentrate on all the important topics which I told you. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more such wonderful videos, and also hit the bell icon for more such notification videos. And like and share this video with all your friends. All the very best for the students who are going to give this exam in the coming up shifts or in the future. So thanks for watching. All the very best for you all. Subscribe and hit the bell icon, like and share. Don't forget to watch my videos, which are very useful for the coming up students, coming up ship students. So thanks for watching. All the very best.